I love failure. The indomitable will, if you have a belief, you can do something. The only way you grow that, like in the gym, you grow your muscles by actually exercising them. You know, you grow the love of you and your wife by caring for them and having their back. To grow the individual will to become something, you must get comfortable with fear and failure.
When you're afraid of something, you have to master it. That's how you start to overcome it. I was so afraid of myself that I had to figure out, I became a master of my mind. So what I realized, when I get to that point where I want to quit, everybody, I get to the point where they want to quit, this is what happens.
You're talented. You just don't want to give up sleep. It's not that you, listen to me, pound for pound, any agent in the room, pound for pound, motivational speaker, pound for pound, entrepreneur, pound for pound, athlete, pound for pound, weightlifter, pound for pound, whatever you do, I guarantee you, when you do it, nobody can do it like you do it. The problem is you don't hardly do it.
One person with a belief overrides thousands of people with just intent. Jaw jabbing, just trying to, you know, fake it till they make it. LA base, not the Gold Coast. Your life, guys, is not about making money. It's not about having the titles. It's not about having the hot trophy wife. Your life is about a moment to come. It's inevitable.
Oh, you know what's so funny? We want people to make guarantees to us, but we're not willing to make guarantees to ourselves. No, bro, I'm going to say it again. Like, somebody gave you a guarantee, $30, 30-day guarantee. In 30 days, if you don't make what they told you you're going to make, in 30 days, you got an attitude, you want your money back. But you've never demanded your money back from yourself. You've never looked at yourself in the mirror and said, you let you down. Until you get to that point, you let you down. You're not brave enough. You want to put it on somebody else. The reason why I'm not successful is because of my boss. Have you ever looked at yourself in the mirror and said, I'm not getting up on time. I'm not going to work on time. I'm not putting in 120% when I'm at work. I let me down. And when you get to the point where you can say you let you down, I don't care. Listen to me, no disrespect. I don't care about Glenn. That's not why I do what I do. And I love Glenn. I don't come here and do what I do so Glenn can affirm me, so he can give me a pat on my back. I care more about me than I care about what Glenn thinks about me.
Success, guys, is a very, very lonely road, man. Along that road, you're not going to see too many friends. You're going to see your shadow most often. See, the thing is, for many people, they've tried the same path you're on, and they failed. You don't burn out mentally, because you always burn out physically. You got trust in the heart of hearts, inside what you're doing, what you believe in, is a worthy cause, a winnable fight. If you allow it to sit, it will grow roots and start breaking you down, destroying the potential of the person you can be. The champions, guys, it's not their potential, it's not their genetics. It's their perseverance to always show up. What I'm saying is the character of who you are. It's not the title that makes you. It's not the success that makes you. The character defines the success, defines the fame, and it starts right there. It's how you look at something. If your name's attached to it, then you do it right. The best of your ability every single time. Championships aren't won in the theater of the arena. They're won in thousands of hours in the training room, in the labs, in the 5 a.m. runs, when it's raining, whenever else is sleeping. That's when it's won. The heart of a champion is a light switch that's always on. It doesn't go on and off when someone's watching. It's constant. Fear is self-imposed, meaning it doesn't exist. You create it, you can destroy it too. I love fear. The reason why? Behind every fear is the person you want to be. You face your fears, you become the person you want to be. You run from your fears, you're not living. You're alive, but you're not thinking of freedom. If you face your fears, guys, that fear is destroyed. It comes back in its confidence. Where else am I capable of? Where else am I holding my back from that I'm capable of more? Where am I running from I don't need to? Where else can I overcome? When you walk this journey, you must know that it's going to go down before it comes up. But when it comes up, it's going to go so much higher than you've ever been. If you can't, right now, there's no one looking, man. Between a winner and a loser, this is the winner gets back up and does it again. It does it again until it goes his way.
The moment has come, and there will be obstacles that you must face. And for each obstacle, it will represent something about you. Your greatest victories, your greatest failures. But nevertheless, you must rise above it, and you must conquer every obstacle that comes your way. Are you strong enough? Are you willing enough? Do you have what it takes to do what's necessary to adapt and overcome? This is the moment that every living person that is at the start line is ready to cross the finish line. Along this journey, you will be pushed, you will be knocked down, but you don't stay down. You must rise up, you must carry on, you must dig deep, you must fight forward. You are not done yet. You carry on. The journey must carry on. You fight to the end. If you feel weak, find a way to rise up. If you feel you can't carry on, then you must find another way to push on. If you get knocked down, then you crawl. If you can't crawl, then you roll. You don't stop. You push up. Bad things have to happen in our lives, ladies and gentlemen. We have to go through certain things, and this is what's going to make us better. This is what's going to make us stronger. But you got to claim what it is that you are seeking in your life. Everybody is never going to be where they want to be in life because sometimes they focus too much on the bad things and not claiming the good times. Not claiming, hey, no matter what struggle I go through, I am going to make it. The beauty about the process is that you're learning something.
You need a plan to get rich, right? Most people have, everyone out there has a dream, but very few people have a plan. If you're surrounded by people who have a plan to get rich and you provide value to them in some way, because they're not going to drag you up, you ain't doing nothing, because that's what friendship is. Friendship is value exchange.
Yeah.
If you provide value to them, sooner or later, you're going to begin to make money.
Let me tell you a fact, number one facet of a G mindset. Your life is never going to be worse if you walk through the world believing you are the man. You wake up, you look in the mirror and go, I'm the man. I am the man. There's no one on this planet who can do I couldn't do if I put my mind to it. I don't give a how good you are at piano. If I decide to play piano, I would be better than you at piano. And I believe that. I don't just say these things. Believe them. So the first thing you can do with your G mindset is you need to start believing you are the man. Even if you're not the man yet, even before I was world champion, I knew I was going to be the man. So I don't give a and I was happy to say that to anybody. When people called me arrogant and stupid and deluded, I just sit there and look at them and say, yeah, you. I'm going to be the man.